نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم، أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Number one, Islamic history. The first Hajj in Islam. The Hajj is one of the five pillars of Islam, which was made fard, obligatory, during the year 9 AH. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam therefore sent Hazrat Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu as the Amir of the Hajj to fulfill this obligation. A caravan of 300 people left with Hazrat Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sent Hazrat Ali radiyallahu anhu afterwards with instructions to make an announcement on the day of Mina when all the people would be gathered together. The announcement was that no kafir shall enter Jannah, that no mushrik will be allowed to perform Hajj after that year, and that none would be permitted to perform tawaf naked, as was the custom amongst the mushrikeen. This was the first Hajj in Islam. Hazrat Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu was the Amir and Hazrat Ali radiyallahu anhu was the speaker. Number two, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's miracle. A tree testifies to the Risalat, prophethood of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hazrat Abdullah bin Umar radiyallahu anhu reports that they were once on a journey with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when a Bedouin came up to him. "Will you testify that there is none worthy of worship but Allah, that he has no partner, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the servant and Rasul, messenger of Allah?" "Who is your witness to this?" the Bedouin asked. "That Salam tree," Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied. The tree was standing at the end of the plain, and when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called it, it cut a path through the ground as it came up to him. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked it to testify thrice, and it testified three times that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was indeed the Rasul, messenger of Allah. It then returned to its place. Darmi 16. Number 3. A fard. Missing a salah without a valid excuse. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "When a person performs two salah during the time of any one salah without a valid excuse, he will have reached one of the doors of the major sins." Mustadrak of Hakim, Hadith 1020 from Hazrat Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhu. Number 4. A sunnah. The dua for protection against poverty and kufr. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prescribed the following dua for protection against kufr and poverty. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-kufri wal-faqri wa'adhab al-qabr. Translation: O Allah, I seek your protection against kufr, poverty and punishment in the grave. Nasai, Hadith 5467 from Hazrat Muslim bin Abu Bakr radiyallahu anhu. Number 5. An important act and its virtue. Giving someone clothing to wear. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "When a person gives another clothing to wear, he will remain in Allah's protection for as long as the clothing remains on the recipient's body." Mustadrak of Hakim, Hadith 7422 from Hazrat Abdullah bin Abbas radiyallahu anhu. Number 6. A sin. Neglecting salah. Allah says in the Quran, "Destruction be for those performers of salah, those Muslims who ought to be performing salah, who neglect to perform their salah. Those who, when they do any good deed like performing salah, are ostentatious, do it to show off before others. Surah Ma'un, verses 4 to 6. Number 7. This world. Wealth is a test. Allah says in the Quran, as for man, instead of learning from the incidents of the past, he takes no heed. And when his Rabb tests him to see whether he's grateful to Allah by granting him honor and favors, he says, my Rabb has honored me because I'm his chosen one and deserve this. Instead of expressing thanks to Allah and using the wealth and favors in a manner that pleases Allah, he becomes proud and conceited. Surah Fajr, verse 15. Number 8. The Akhirah. Three doomed people on the day of Qiyamah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, on the day of Qiyamah, a neck will emerge from Jahannam that will have two eyes to see, two ears to hear, and a tongue to speak. It will say, three types of people will be made over to me. Number one, every such person who is proud and turns away from the truth despite knowing that it is the truth. Number two, every person who calls to a deity other than Allah. And number three, every person who makes a picture. Shu'b al-Iman, Hadith 6084 from Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. Number 9. Cures from the Quran and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A cure from fever. Hazrat Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu anhu reports that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught the Sahaba radiallahu anhum to recite the following dua when suffering from fever. Bismillahil Kabiri, A'udhu billahi al-azim min sharri kulli 'irqin na'arin wa min sharri harrin nar. Translation, I begin in the name of Allah the Great. I seek the protection of the glorious Allah from the evil of every boiling vein and from the evil of the heat of the fire. Tirmizi, 2075. Number 10. Advice from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, O Ali, never delay with three things. Number one, salah when its time arrives. Number two, burial when the body is ready. And number three, the marriage of a single woman when a suitable match is found. Tirmizi, Hadith 171 from Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين